Hey guys, what I want to discuss today is scientific journals for the MCAT as a twist on the newspaper strategy, which is something you can find on my website. I put the URL in the comments, so let me know if you find that helpful. Let's see what we have. I have a quick outline. So the first question, why scientific journals? If you've been following the changes to the MCAT in the last few years, in 2015, the new MCAT came out where there's a lot more focus on research and data analysis. And many of the passages are actually taken out of research articles. So there's the aspect for MCAT prep where you study the content and you do practice passages. But then a lot of students say that they can follow along for the most part, but the experiments become overwhelming. One way that you prepare for these types of passages, one way that you get comfortable following the logic of a confusing and in-depth experiment is by reading scientific journals. The more you read, the more you get familiar with the language, the data, the structure, the format, the less confused you'll be on the MCAT. So the purpose is to practice in advance so that you're confident with that aspect and you can take your mental power and focus on the questioning, on the reasoning, on all the other good stuff that'll give you points. When should you be reading the journals and how often? The closer you are to your MCAT, the more you want to do it, especially if this is something you're just starting out. For those of you testing this year, you don't have a lot of time, I would recommend, if possible, even 1 hour a day if you can. And the way you would break it up would be ideally every other day, a scientific journal, and every other day, something related to cars, like boring articles on, I say boring because I find them boring, anywhere from economics, politics, religion, art, music, history, anything that's not science, because you're pre-meds. Science is our thing, right? So these are the other topics that you're not interested in, but you want to get comfortable with. Today, I want to focus on the science aspect, though. Every other day, expose yourself to some type of scientific journal. If it's long, if it's detailed, if it's tedious, if there are graphs and tables and charts, you're on the right track. If you're bored and you hate it, you're on the right track. Unfortunately, that is what it's going to take. If you're just starting out because you're preparing for next year, then you don't want to go as crazy. You want to do a long-term integration, a long-term strategy. For example, maybe set aside 1 to 2 days a week where you spend an hour or so reading. And then as you get closer to the MCAT, maybe up it to 3 times a week, but you should be okay. I mean, if you're thinking between now and January, you have months and months, 2 to 3 hours a week, you will be very, very comfortable by the time your MCAT rolls around. How to read them? That's a very good question. So you don't want to treat this like your textbook where you read it from start to finish, you fly through, you don't follow anything, and you get overwhelmed, and you don't remember anything. You also don't want to read it from the perspective of, let me learn what this is about. Because this article could be on something that is very, very in-depth, and if you try to learn every term and every enzyme and every crazy little thing, you're going to be overwhelmed. So I want you to treat this like you do any other science passage on the MCAT. You are reading for the single purpose of getting the main idea, understanding what is going on, but not looking up every definition, not looking up every factor. So start the article from the beginning and just read the first sentence. Ask yourself, what was the point? What was the main idea? Don't worry about the names, the enzymes, the molecules, the pathways, none of that. What was the main idea? Why did they bother writing this? Then go to the next sentence. When you get through the entire paragraph, stop for a minute and think, what was the purpose of all of this? Then go to the next paragraph and the next one. Now here's the thing. Some of these articles will take a long, long time. You don't have to finish them. If your goal is to read for an hour and the first article takes you 40 minutes and the second article takes you till the top of the hour and you're only halfway through, you can stop there. It's about the exercise of doing it rather than completing the story, because you're not looking to learn the science, you're looking to learn how to understand when you read the science. So the purpose again is not to learn, it's to learn how to read, how to be comfortable with it. Which subjects should you be reading? Ideally, everything. So each day, try to focus on one type of science that relates to the MCAT. For example, a chemistry passage, a physics, chemistry journal article, a physics journal article, organic chemistry, biology, biochemistry, psychology, and sociology. If you can continually expose yourself to each type of research, then no matter what they throw at you during the MCAT, you will be prepared because you will have seen everything in some format and it won't scare you when you see those big words or multiple steps and crazy experiments that they ran. You've seen it before. That's the goal. Where are you going to find these articles? That's the million-dollar questions. There is so much good research out there that to tell you to stick to one is limiting yourself. So instead, give yourself a very simple rule. If it's long, if it's hard, if it's boring, if it looks legit, it's good enough. So where do you find them? Honestly, anywhere. For example, if you have friends who are doing research, either in class or work in a lab, ask them what some of the sources are that they use for their research, and if they recommend it, you can read some of that. Go on, here's one that I like to do. If you hear about a scientific topic that interests you, go on Wikipedia and not necessarily focus on the wiki article because they're not always the type that you want. Instead, go to the very bottom and look for the sources. For example, I was looking up a Zika vaccine and there were some interesting sources which led down a rabbit hole and I got to read some pretty interesting research. Then you have, you can do a Google search like scientific evidence for, and you can follow anything that interests you. Look up diabetes medication, look up viruses, vaccines, genetics, whatever interests you, try to find a scientific research subject related to that, and you can use that. Don't always find what interests you though. You want to get comfortable reading what bores you as well. Try to look for articles that were published within the last 5 to 10 years because students who have taken the MCAT say that's typically what they see. If it's too old, the research might be outdated. If it's too new, it might not show up on the MCAT because they're looking for the last 5 to 10 years is ideal in terms of a general rule. There could be exceptions. That's the general rule. If you want specific examples, here are some of the ones that I have seen and used with students in sessions. Google NCBI and PubMed. There's a site aeon.co and nature.com. These are just the ones that I have off the top of my head. And again, anything legit works. So if you have any questions on scientific journal reading as it relates to the MCAT, go ahead and post it here. I know that I picked a random time during the day when not a lot of students are on, so I'll give you a chance to watch it later and read your comments and hope to answer all of your questions. If you need help preparing for the MCAT, I have seen and heard so many horror stories of students not being prepared the right way, and frankly, I got sick and tired of hearing their horror stories, so I took matters into my own hands and I have made it so that you have no excuse. I published a guide called The Ultimate Guide to MCAT Prep, and the goal is to have everything that you would need to know to understand what the MCAT is all about, when to study, how to study, all of that, and it's free on my website, so you have no excuses. The URL, I'll put it into the description, is leahforsci.com/ultimate, and that will take you to the homepage and that will link all the chapters. With that, guys, have a great day.